Here, I'm going to show you how to make a dynamic heat map in Excel so that you can sift through your large datasets to better understand what is going on. And I'm going to show you how to do this where we have days of the week on the side and hours of the day above it. As well, I'll show you how to customize the data that you filter on here so that it's going to work best for your dataset. And this tutorial comes from teachexcel.com, where we have online Excel courses that show you how to save hours of time every week. I'll put a link to those courses below this video. Give them a look. Now, let me show you what you have to do to make this heat map. And first things first is to tell you what this is. This right here is a pivot table. If we bring back the field list, you can see here we can create, update, manage the pivot table. These are slicers that we created from this pivot table. Now, in order to create this, we have to go back to the raw data. This is our raw data. Over 60,000 rows of user analytics completely anonymized for this tutorial. So all we have is a row ID, day since sign up, the screen, and the date time. Now, the most important thing here is going to be the date time. So import your data into Excel. And now we're going to play around with it, slice it and dice it every way that we need to before we create the pivot table. Step one, copy and paste your data into Excel. Step two, click anywhere inside of your data and then go to Insert and Table. This is already a table, so we are good to go. Step three, go to your date time column. You need this in order to create the heat map because the heat map goes across days of the week and hours of the day. And you can click in the datetime column, then go to Home and check the number format. Here it is, Custom. To see exactly the format, click this little guy right here. We can see it's a custom number format, month, day, year, hours, and minutes. Perfect. We don't need a specific format. We just need to make sure it is a date time. The other trick, by the way, is to go to the Home tab and set it to General. Once you do that, you're going to see a number with a decimal. And that's a pretty good indication that you have a date time. Now, helper columns. That's the next step. Notice here I have a 30 plus day retention, day of week, hour of day, and month. Notice here on the heat map, 30 plus day retention, then we have screen, then we have month. So here we have two helper columns used for our slicers, month and 30 day retention. Whatever you want to slice and dice your data by, make sure that you add a helper column for that. It's going to make your life so much easier. So let's go with 30-day retention. What do I want to use to filter upon 30-day retention? I've got days since sign up over here, but I don't want to filter by this. Look at this. A number with a bunch of decimals because it comes from a datetime field. That's not very helpful. Let filter by true, false. So a little formula equals if this greater than or equal to 30, comma. Now, what do I want to output? Whatever text you want to show up in that slicer, whatever's going to make it easier for you to work with your heat map. Here, let's just go with true and false. Since we have a table, it's going to fill everything all the way down. And I do not need this formula any longer. I've got the values I need. So I'm going to go ahead and select the very top cell, Control Shift Down. Control C to copy, Alt E S V to paste special values. Enter, escape, double click. Now all we have are true false values. Next up, day of the week. Once again, this is what do you want to be displayed over here in the heat map? But it's for this right here, this column. You could use numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. But it's a little bit nicer to use the actual days themselves. To use numbers, it would be equals weekday, date, and then select how you want it to return the numbers from over here. Then you get numbers, but let's do the days. Equals text, date time, quote, DD, DD, close, close, enter. There you go. Hour of the day, very easy, equals hour, the date, enter, perfect, month equals month, the date, perfect. Now, let us copy-paste special values once again. That'll make going through the data a bit faster. Next up, click in the dataset, Insert, Pivot Table. New worksheet, okay. Let's go grab day of week, put it for rows. There we go, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Next up, hour of day for the columns. And let us grab row, put it in values. Row in this case, let's take a quick look. Row is merely a unique identifier for each item. That's all it is. So in order for our pivot table to work correctly, we do not want to sum them. We want to count how many times they occur. How many times did a user go to this screen? And then how many times did they do that on this day of the week at this time? So we can click here. Off the screen, we have value field settings. And change sum to count. Okay. And if you have a robot eyes, you've got your heat map already. So the only thing we're going to do for the next steps is formatting and then adding in the slicers, which just make it easier to go through our data. Let's click in the pivot table, go to design, and we can take away the grand totals off for rows and columns. Don't need those. Select our values in here, then go to home, conditional formatting, color scales, and choose the one that you want. How about this one? Next formatting trick, right click, value field settings, number format, custom, delete that, semicolon, 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 three semicolons. Okay. Okay. And the numbers are gone. Now we're starting to get a heat map. We can now move this guy. How about we go down to row 9? Then let's click here, go to pivot table analyze, insert slicer. Now you can use a timeline, but I do not like them. And we have enough helper columns that we can still sort by dates and times without it. So go to insert slicer. And I would like 30-day retention. Screen, which was not a helper column. It's already how we want it to be. And how about month? Okay. And now we have our three slicers. Next up, it's just about formatting, getting it to look how you'd like it to look. So we can click this guy, go to slicer, add another column. That will allow us to make it much smaller. For the screen, we can do the same thing. Add as many columns as you need. Make it as wide as you need. I've got a title. The slicers are all there. Let's go ahead and make it so that these columns are all the same size. Maybe like that. And we could play around with it until we get it to look however we need it to look. And a very important final update, make it so this doesn't change size when you use the filters up here. So if I do this, it's already changed. So click in the pivot table, go to pivot table analyze, pivot table, options, uncheck auto fit column widths on update. And there we go. If you like this tutorial, make sure to subscribe, hit the bell icon, and give us a thumbs up. And don't forget that we have more courses on automating your workflows in Excel on teachexcel.com. Give those courses a look. I'll put a link to them below this video. That's all for this tutorial. See you next time.